ಚಾನೆಲ್ ಅನ್ನು ಸಬ್ಸ್ಕ್ರೈಬ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಮತ್ತು ಪಕ್ಕದಲ್ಲಿರುವ ಬೆಲ್ ಬಟನ್ ಅನ್ನು ಕ್ಲಿಕ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಮುಂದೆ ಅಪ್ಲೋಡ್ ಮಾಡುವ ಎಲ್ಲ ಹೊಸ ವಿಡಿಯೋಗಳ ನೋಟಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್ ಅನ್ನು ತಪ್ಪದೇ ಪಡೆಯಿರಿ.
In this experiment, we'll give information regarding how to perform single cantilever experiment. The aim of experiment is to determine the Young's modulus of the given material using single cantilever.
The apparatus required for this experiment are meter scale, that is one of the material. This is a meter scale. For this material, we have to find the Young's modulus. Some slotted weights. So these are the slotted weights, each of having 50 grams. This is a 50 gram slotted weights. Next we need a traveling microscope. So this is the traveling microscope and other things like a table lamp to read the main scale readings and the vernier readings. Then to find the Young's modulus, we are using this formula, that is Y is equal to 4mZL cube divided by BXD cube, where Y is the Young's modulus of the given material, G is the acceleration due to gravity, L is the length of the cantilever from here to here, this is the length of cantilever, B is the breadth of cantilever, this is the breadth of cantilever, D is the thickness of the cantilever, this is the thickness of the cantilever, M is the applied mass, so at the free end, this is the what we are applying, this is the applied mass. And X is the diffraction at the open end, that is due to load. So this cantilever is getting diffraction, so that diffraction can be measured as X. So this is the formula we are using to find the Young's modulus in this experiment. So next, the experimental setups are, so this is the single cantilever experiment where the material, that is a steel scale, is taken as a material where the one end is fixed and other end is free. So therefore this setup is called as the single cantilever. To find the depression, we are using this traveling microscope. Then in this experiment, the observations, to find the value of Young's modulus, we need all these observations. For example, the breadth of the beam as B, so which can be measured using the vernier calipers. However, in this experiment it is already measured and given for this material. This is the B value here we mentioned. This is the nearly 2.42 centimeter, and take that value and write here. That value, noted that value and write here 4.2 centimeter, and convert this in terms of meters, that is 2.42 into 10 raised to minus 2 meters. And thickness of the beam we can measure using the screw gauge. However, in this experiment it is already given. This is the thickness of the given material, that is D is equal to 0.92 mm. Take this value and note it here, 0.92 mm. Mm means 0.92, that is 10 raised to minus 3 meter. Next, L is the length of cantilever, that is from this fixed point to this free end. So that is already, that is also given. So here the length of the cantilever is given, that is L is equal to 20 centimeter. So right here, L is equal to 20 centimeter, and can be, in terms of meter, we can write it as 20 into 10 raised to minus 2 meters. And anyway, acceleration due to gravity is constant, that is G is equal to 9.8 meter per second square. Then to find the depression, we are using traveling microscope. So this traveling microscope has its least count, and that least count can be measured using the formula as shown here, that is LC is equal to value of 1 MST divided by total number of VST. Then how to find this LC? So let me explain here. The value of 1 MST, so where this is the traveling microscope, so this is the scale. This scale is known as the main scale. So here it is running from 0 to 1, 2, 3 and so on up to 50. So this scale is known as the main scale. And in addition to that, we have one more scale. So this is the scale. So this scale is considered as vernier scale, that is VST. To note on the VST, we are using this scale. Then to find the LC of this traveling microscope, the same scale is here also. We have here also the same scale. So just let me explain how to find the LC of this one. Either you can find the LC using this one or this one, because both scales are same. Both scales are same. Then to find the LC, the formula is, note down the value of 1 MST, that is main scale division. For example here, so this is the main scale. This is the main scale. So this is the main scale. So to find the value of 1 MST, for example, I am considering here 0 to 1. This is the main 0 to 1. So note on the value of 0 and next 1. Can count the number of divisions from 0 to 1. If you count this one, so we have total 20 divisions. For example, 0, this is 1, 2, 3, 4. Likewise, there are total 20 divisions are there between 0 and 1. We need the value of 1 MST, that is the what is the value of the first division to the next division. So this value we can get by, that is, total number of divisions between 0 and 1 is 20. Then value of 1 MST can be noted as 1 divided by 20. So which gives the value of 1 MST, because we have the total divisions between the main scale 0 and 1 is 20 divisions. In that, value of 1 MST is, that is, 1 by 20 at times. So that is how we can note down the value of 1 MST divided by the total number of VST. So here we have VST. This is a VST, or you can take this one also, either this one or this one. So this is the VST. So if it's read the value of VST starting from this arrow mark and count all the number of divisions from this arrow mark to the last divisions. Suppose if you want to count this one, so I'll just count this one. This is one, first arrow mark is the, from here to here we have 1 division, 2 division, 3 division, likewise 4, 5, then from here we have 10. This is the 10 division, likewise this is the 20 division, 30, 40, 50. So likewise we have total number of divisions on the vernier scale is 50 divisions. Right here, this is the total number of VST is 50. And calculate this value. 1 divided by 20 is 0.05 divided by 50.
Next, and the value will be explain 0.001
centimeter. Young's modulus, we need all these parameters. From the observation, we can get B value, D value, L value and G value. In this formula, only we need to find the value of mass and diffraction. So now we can find the diffraction as a function of load from this table. So this is the table. We can determine the diffraction produced in the single cantilever as a function of load, as shown here. Okay, to get this one, so we have to set up the experiment as shown here. So this is the single cantilever, and now first point is to set up the viewpoint of this pin point, that is needle of this one, in the view of microscope. That is the first point we have to set up. So for that reason, approximately place this traveling microscope in the view of, that is the tip of this needle can be observed in the view of this microscopic view. So that is the first approximation. First approximately we can get that view of this needle in the traveling microscope view. Then gradually, by observing through the microscope, so just put this traveling microscope so that we can observe that needle point in the traveling microscope view. So now just adjusted, so this needle can be viewed through the traveling microscope here. So now it is, we can see clearly the inverted image of this needle in the traveling microscope view. You can pause mark. Where to set the height of this traveling microscope, we can use this knob. So this is the one screw we have here. If you lose this one, I can adjust the height of this traveling microscope using this knob. Once in this way, we get this needle in the view of traveling microscope, just fix it. So here, I have adjusted the tip of this needle in the view of traveling microscope. So as shown here. This wire in the field view of this traveling microscope. So this is the field of traveling microscope. We have cross wires, horizontal and vertical. So where we have inverted image of this needle in the traveling microscope field view, as shown in this diagram. So this is looking in the form of inverted image. So this is the needle what we have. The tip of the needle exactly coincides this horizontal cross wire of this horizontal line. So we have to make this adjustment by setting the height of the traveling microscope using this knob. I can adjust the height of this one. And by the gradual backward or forward motion of this traveling microscope in the viewpoint of this needle in the traveling microscope. So once if you set this one, and now we can find the depression as a function of load using this table. Now we can find the depression of the single cantilever produced as a function of load in this manner. So where this is the single cantilever where we have not at loaded anything in the free end of the single cantilever. So therefore I can write the first reading as 0 gram, that is where there is no load at the free end of the single cantilever. So this is the first reading, 0 load. And note on the value of MSR and CVD of the traveling microscope. Now how to note on this MSR and CVD? I will just explain one reading. Once if you set like this in the field view of traveling microscope, this is the needle, inverted image of this one, and just adjust the height of the traveling microscope, just this tip touches the horizontal cross wire. Once if it is done in the absence of load, that is M is equal to 0 gram, then at this position note down the value of MSR and CVD as shown here. So where this is the scale MSR, this is the scale MSR, and this is the scale CVD. So now to get the MSR value, consider the arrow mark of the CVD. This is the vernier scale where it is exactly coincides with the main scale. For example, in this example, this is 12.05, 12.1, this is 12.15. So here the first arrow mark of this vernier scale coincides with 12.15. So therefore this is 12, this is 12.1, this is 12.15. So this is the MSR value. So MSR can be noted down where the CVD of this arrow reference line coincides with which division of this main scale. So that can be taken as MSR value. So I am writing in this example, so the value of MSR is, for this load MSR is 12.15. Okay, next is to find once if it is noted down this as MSR, next our job is to find what is the CVD value. CVD can be noted with one of the division using this vernier scale where we have total 50 divisions. Out of 50 divisions, one of the division is exactly coincide with the main scale. This is the main scale. So let me consider one by one. So here, so carefully observe the which division is coincides with the main scale. So that division we have to note it as a CVD. For example, in this example, The value of CVD is, if you look carefully, each division of the vernier scale, for example, this is 1, 2nd division, 3rd division, 5th division, 6th division, likewise, if you note down carefully of all the divisions here, the, for example, in this case, the 10th division is exactly coincide with one of the division of the, this main scale. So therefore, I can consider this one 10th division as the CVD value. So where, I repeat, the CVD, that is the 10th division of this scale, the 10th division of this scale is exactly coincide with main scale. So therefore, CVD value should be 10. So this is the 10. So write down the value of CVD as 10. Once if you note down the value of MSR and CVD, calculate the total reading using this formula where total reading is equal to MSR plus CVD into LC. So I will just calculate 1. So MSR is now 12.15 plus CVD is now 10 into LC is, so we already noted the value of LC as 0.001 and substitute here. That is 0.001. Calculate this value, you will get the depression of the single cantilever when the load is equal to 0. So you will have some value. So that value is the depression of the single cantilever when there is no load. Next, increase the load. That is, apply the load, for example, 50 gram at the free end of the single cantilever. So I'm loading. I'm applying the load of 50 gram. So when you apply the load of 50 gram, so we can observe that the single cantilever, that is free end, we have some depression at the free end, so that this needle will go downwards. So to find how much depression what we have without load and with this load, so to find that, now adjust the height of this traveling microscope by using this knob, that is by rotating this one, we can adjust the height now. So initially, in absence of load, here we have, once if you apply the load, say for example 50 gram, so this needle may go here, maybe upward. So to get again this needle to this horizontal cross wire, so we have to adjust the height of the traveling microscope. Again, it has to touch. Again, it has to touch the horizontal cross wire of this one. So the, if you do so, now we have to make adjustments such that the traveling microscope height, that is the inverted image of this needle now, has to touch the horizontal line of the cross wire. So to do that, I am just adjusting this one. The height of this one adjusted by observing the tip of the needle. Again, it has to touch the horizontal line of this one. At this point, now note down the value of, again, as I explained, the MSR value and CVD value and calculate the total reading. And similarly, repeat the same procedure by applying the load, for example, 100. Next, apply the load 100. Again, adjust the height of this traveling microscope, where the tip of this inverted tip image of this one can just touch the horizontal cross wire. At that point, note down the value of MSR, CVD and total reading. Likewise, you can repeat the same procedure by applying the different loads, that is 150, 200, 250, 300. Likewise, we can note on all the readings, that is MSR and CVD and corresponding total reading. Once, if you reach the last reading, so where, for example, this is my last reading. For example, this is the last reading. I can adjust this one height by taking this one. So next, we can repeat the same procedure for now load decreasing. This is the load decreasing, and note on the value of MSR and CVD for this reading, and write here the total reading. And now for the decreasing, remove the load one by one. Again, adjust the height of the traveling microscope, note on the MSR and CVD, and write the total reading. Next, repeat the same by removing the loads. Likewise, we can remove the load by 50 grams intervals, note on the corresponding MSR and CVD, and calculate the value of total reading. So this is for the load decreasing. So I repeat, so here we are increasing the load, here we are decreasing the load. So note on the total reading, that is calculate the total reading for load increasing and decreasing. Then to find the depression, take the average of total reading increasing and decreasing, that is A plus B divided by 2, and calculate that and substitute the value here, and similar repeat for the remaining readings. Once if you find this depression as a function of mass, next plot the graph of depression versus mass, that is 0, 50, 100, 200, likewise, and along the y-axis depression values. And note on the value, for example, when you have the load 0, note the value of depression, and 50 gram likewise. So we can plot the graph. So as a function of mass, the depression can be plotted like this. From this plot, take the slope, that is take the slope ABC. From this plot we can find the slope. We can find the slope as AB divided by BC. Note on the value, what is the value of AB, and note on the value, what is the value of BC, and substitute here, and you can find the value of slope. So this slope can be used to calculate the Young's modulus with a, once if you note this slope, that is AB value and BC value, that is in terms of, because we consider this depression in terms of centimeter and mass in terms of gram. So we need to convert that centimeter to meter and gram to kg. So where centimeter to meter, just multiplication of 10 raised to minus 2. Gram to kg, that is multiplication of 10 raised to minus 3. So if we substitute these two parameters, we can convert this centimeter to meter, gram to kg. And take this value, this obtained value, to determine the value of Young's modulus, where the formula is 4mgl cube divided by bxd cube, where 4gl cube divided by bd cube, where the slope gives, actually AB means this is the value of depression, BC means value of mass, but actually here in this formula we need mass divided by depression. From the plot we got X divided by M, that is depression divided by mass. So to get that, so this value has to be in the, or has to take in terms of reciprocal. So therefore we can substitute this 4GL cube, that is 1 divided by slope value, where G is already known, substitute the G value. Next L value is already given, substitute this L value. And B value is already given, that is B value. And next D value is also given. And from this plot we can find the value of slope, substitute here, and finally we can calculate the value of Young's modulus.